Get ready, Ohio. FanDuel, America's number one sportsbook, is coming to the Buckeye State. And to kick things off, you can get started with $100 in free bets as an early sign-up bonus. Plus, when you sign up today with promo code OhioSB, you'll be all set for when FanDuel goes live in Ohio. Then you can bet on all your favorite teams and all your favorite sports with $100 in free bets. Just download FanDuel's top-rated sportsbook app. It's safe, secure, and super easy to use. Ohio, this is your chance to get in on the action. Join today with promo code OhioSB. Make every moment more with FanDuel, official sportsbook partner of the NFL. 21 plus and present in Ohio. Bonus issued in non-withdrawable free bets that expire 7 days after FanDuel accepts its first real money sports wager in Ohio on 1/1/23. Unique user identity verification required. Offer ends on the go live date. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
At the Home Depot, we have the tools for you to give the gift of a smarter home with savings on top brands, like the Google Hub, a command center for your smart devices that raises the IQ of your entire home, or the Nest Learning Thermostat that helps you conserve energy and save on your bill. And if you don't know what to get, gift cards are a smart gift no matter what they get. So this year, gift smarter with savings on tools to make your holiday magic. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
Hey, man, did you hear that?
Hey, everybody, Santa's here!
Aw, there ain't no Santa Claus.
Yes, there is.
There is, too, man.
He's here!
Swinging hamsters, get over here. Right. We're gonna sing us a happy Christmas song.
Oh, no, not another corny, stupid song.
Yeah, no way,
Dan. You tell him, Ronnie.
Yeah, no way. No
get
way.
Over here and sing, or I'll wring your little neck.
Okay.
Grab your nuts, hamsters, gather round with me. Forget about all that teasing. We're breaking out the holly and aluminum tree, cause it's that jolly season. I know you've been naughty, but have you been nice? That's only Santa's business.
That's right, Red.
He's making his list and he's checking it twice.
Holy shit, it's Christmas.
Santa comes just once a year.
Tell him, him.
Just like you, Red, that's what we need.
Hey, wait a
minute. He's got a soft spot for reindeer.
Oh, that's nice.
Especially Rudolph's derriere.
Hey, knock it off, fellas, it's a holiday. Go on and give Santa a big kiss.
No way.
You can play hide the hamster on a one-horse sleigh.
Hey, wait a minute.
Holy shit, it's Christmas.
Hey, what happened to my lyric sheet? Anyone seen my lyrics?
Heck, we don't need no lyric sheets, Red. We know our parts by heart. Right, fellas?
Yeah, sure. I know my part, Concrete.
Yeah, me too.
Well, that's great, guys. I love Christmas songs.
Santa tried reaching up the neighbor's blouse after drinking all the eggnog.
Is that necessary?
Camped out in the bathroom for an hour or two, squashing off a Yule log.
Godfrey!
We wandered in his undies all over the house, but we minded our own business.
Oh, till we caught something hamsters up a gift wrap too. Holy shit, it's Christmas.
Santa comes just once a year. Up the chimney, he'll disappear.
Keep on the lookout for Mr. Gear. Hamster
delivery in the rear. Roast nuts chesting on an open fire. Santa's tongue stuck to the doorknob. What? His balls got funneled by a caroling choir while the parson gave him a hit. What? The sleigh came down and took him away. The whole damn crowd was dismissed.
Cause it's time to be jolly and it's time to be gay. Holy shit, it's Christmas.
Holy shit, it's Christmas.
Holy shit, it's Christmas.
Hey, what are you doing?
Holy shit.
Eric Zane Show podcast, a daily show where I discuss news, nonsense, and my personal adventures from the Baldwin Ace Hardware Fear Bunker Studio. Baldwin Ace Hardware, beacon of DIY awesomeness in the Northland. Red Peters getting us started. I remember, I know Red Peters there, who you just heard in the intro. He ended up having a show on Sirius XM and did a lot of fun things with the Howard Stern show. But before that, he was with your old pal, Eric Zane. I'm totally not kidding. He would drive in. I was at Z93, the mobile home of rock and roll. Joe and I would be there doing our thing. And hey, hang on a second. We'd be doing our thing, and Red Peters would join us in the studio to sing these fucking wacky songs that he made. Daisy looking especially comfy and adorable with the leg hanging down. Bruce there. Excuse me. No O'Neill. Now, how embarrassing was it for my wife yesterday? It's bad when you get the text that says, "Would you please call me?" And I'm okay. So I'm like, well, all right. And I looked and I saw my phone was on do not disturb. Problem one. You don't want that. You don't want the queen of the forest trying to get a hold of you. And it's do not disturb time on the phone, which, by the way, I just put it on do not disturb. I don't want to be bothered while I do this show. It's very, very important. Text message. Please call me. I call. And she's upset. She's annoyed. I'm so damn embarrassed. And I go, what's up? I went to the dollar store and our card got declined at the dollar store. Like, oh shit. So, there's all these people in line buying whatever you buy at the dollar store, whatever she was getting. And card wouldn't work. I don't know how the fuck I met. There was a time when people used to balance checkbooks. And, money that is there and then checks outstanding that have not come back yet. You have to subtract them from what you think is the balance and to give you the actual balance. You have to get all zeros across this thing. No one knows how to do this anymore you can still experience the trouble when you make payments online through your bank account. And then when you look at the total, oh, yeah, I got plenty of cash in there. And then all that shit that you paid shows up a day later. And then when you thought you were in the black, you're very quickly in the red. So that happened to the queen of the forest. And she goes, we're minus $830. What the fuck are you doing over there? I go, no problem. Okay. But I don't know. Put it on a credit card or something like that. And I'll go to the bank and put some money in there. Oh, was she pissed? She goes, it's so embarrassing with the fucking dollar store. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I actually had to make another trip there later on in the day. They're probably like, oh, no, here he comes again. I need questions for Dear Meathead. Eric at ericzaneshow.com. Okay. I posted a nice picture of Dad on Facebook. I've got a couple, but I always need more. Please, a nice pithy question for Dad. Eric at ericzaneshow.com. Perhaps you're having... You're working on a project at the house and you need maybe just want to hear his thoughts on it. Perhaps there's some type of drama building at the house that's maybe kept you up at night in your life. Or maybe there's something at work going on. Some type of, issue. Maybe it's a good news thing. Maybe it's something you want to share with them. Eric at ericzaneshow.com. On the Shore Liners Striping inbox. I have a joyful update. Oh my gosh. I tell you what, this great food giveaway has really gone fantastic. I'm so happy. I just posted to Facebook the good news. And I'm going to share it with you here. Video check. There you go. Okay. Update, goal met in 1 month. Audience member generosity has led to 5,000. $958 raised for the great food giveaway number 3. More good news, cost for the 200 Christmas dinners went down just before purchase of the food at Meyer. I think I shared that with you yesterday, but I'm sharing it with the Facebook crowd. The original estimate of $5,570 for the food actually came in at $4,420. There it is. And you can see the screenshot, $4,420. That means the excess cash of $1,538 was donated to Kids Food Basket. Important, if you or someone you know or love would like a Christmas dinner, please be at Irvine's Auto Repair, Grand Rapids Hybrid tomorrow. Thanks to all who gave, and please don't feel bad if you could not. Also, if you'd like to help distribute food, please be at Irvine's 2 p.m. tomorrow. That's Thursday, December 22. Thank you. So there you go. There's your receipt for the total amount. Look at that. Pies. Was $1,198 for pies, actually came in at $998. Pies were cheaper. There is a wide shot of the receipt. Look how long that, look how long this damn receipt is. Holy shit. Joshua at Meyer had to put all of this together and, you know, a little bit of logistic things to do all this. And he did that very, very professionally, and I very much appreciate him for the assistance in getting all this done, because he had to kind of like order things, and then it occupied a lot of space inside of the store. So Mike Ball picked up the food yesterday, and it's in my driveway right now, and I cannot wait to show you later on the image of how much food is in there, because we had done 100 families. We had given away to 100 families. And then we doubled it this year. So, holy shit. And then, as promised, just like we said, that extra money, $1,538 today, I sent that along to Kids Food Basket. Your money. Well done. That's exactly what we had planned. If any more comes in, of course, I will shuffle that off to Kids Food Basket, or just give it to them yourself. Easiest way to do that. Take me out of it. So, and then we'll reconvene next year and do this shit all again. Awesome. Thank you for your assistance. I couldn't be more happy. It absolutely has been just great. So tomorrow, that food gets given away. All right. Let's see. Where do I want to go now? Oh, I started making signs. Homespun signs. Yesterday was sign-making day in the Eric Zane Show podcast household. I made this big fucking arrow that says free food, and I bought like little poster board paints, and the Queen of the Forest and I are stenciling out the letters and actually painting free food on a sign, on an arrow. And then I've got another big fucking sign that I made, and I do this with like cardboard to make this big-ass sign, and then I put poster board over the cardboard. And then the sign is going to say, free Xmas dinner for those in need. So the sign is there, and then someone else will have the arrow pointing down the street. So, yeah. Oh, my God. That's it. That's all the preparations we need. And then please share the post that I've made on Facebook, or make your own post, whatever it is. I don't care. Just as long as people that are in need know that on Thursday at 3 p.m., they need to have their vehicle there to have the food put into the car, and then off they go to prepare their big Christmas event. Thanks to you all, my pals at the Grand Rapids Pit Bull Alliance, and they don't just make sure that pit bulls are homed, I guess, or adopted. It's all pets. And they have a army of volunteers and a lot of free pet food to give away. Dog, cat, even rabbit. Oh my God, they've done that in the past. We'll be there putting pet food into the cars. Terry and Beth, longtime audience members. They work for a pharmaceutical company, so they're getting a huge stash of cold medicine for families. And that's actually like as good as gold these days. Hard to get because I guess everybody's sick with one of like 8 million things that are going around right now. So, okay, it's all coming together. I got more sign making to do today. And then tomorrow, sit down here, do the podcasts, free one, Patreon, boom. While I'm doing the show tomorrow, Mike Ball will show up, get the trailer, and take it over to Irvine's. Why didn't Mike Ball just keep the trailer? Well, I had a hope that I would hear from one of the TV stations so that we could kind of use the food as a backdrop and say, yeah, we want everybody to come. But I don't know if that's in the cards, like I indicated yesterday. If they do show up, it'll be day of, and that really doesn't really get the word out to anybody. I mean, that's not why we're doing this, to get attention on day of. We want attention days before so that more people can know about it, but beggars can't be choosers, I guess. All right. Appreciate showing up day of, but we're not doing this to have a feel-good moment to be seen on the news. We're doing this so that hungry people who would be worrying about putting food on the table on Christmas Day won't have to worry about that. That's the point. So, but whatever. Okay. Once again, dear Meathead, Eric at ericzaneshow.com, if you could send a question along. All right. Now, if you're enjoying the show on Twitch, I'm sorry, if you're enjoying the show on Twitch, you are going to stay there. You're going to get the full show uninterrupted. But if you're enjoying the show on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube, it is time to send you on your way. As you know, the full show is available on Twitch uninterrupted. So go to twitch.tv/Eric Zane Live and you get the full show uninterrupted. All right. Follow me on Twitch. Subscribe to the channel with your Amazon Prime account, Twitch Prime, and then you get the show minus any type of commercial interruptions. Hang out.
Hey.
No paw licking, you. I'm talking to you. I can hear it, and you know it goes right to my brain, so none of that. You can sit there and be adorable all you want, but knock it off. You're still doing it. No more paw licking.
Hey.
All right, so you folks on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube about to kick you out. And as always, you can download the audio podcast wherever you download shows, including the iHeart app. Search my name, and there it is. Apple Podcasts, iHeart, Spotify. I'm on all of them. Okay? So thank you, thank you, thank you. And I have a Patreon. Don't forget about that. Ad-free, listener-supported Patreon. If you ever want to help out the show financially, I'm not a, hey, give me money, donate button. I'm more of a sign up and you get 11 bonus shows a week type of guy. For the money that you're putting in my pocket on the ad-free, listener-supported Patreon, you get a ton of content. Content nearly every day of the week. I think about 6, sometimes 7. All right. So thank you so much. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. Facebook and Twitch brought to you by Irvine's Auto Repair, Grand Rapids Hybrid and EV. How about those folks? You're just the best. Facebook, as I said, okay, where am I? I feel like I'm falling apart here. Twitter brought to you by Blue Frost IT. And YouTube brought to you by Frank Fuss, My Policy Shop Insurance. Send an email whenever you want to say hi or share some thoughts. Yell at me, whatever it may be. On the Shoreliners Striping Inbox, Eric@EricZaneShow.com. That's how you do that. For about a week now, I have been hearing discussions about, hey, we're going to get hammered. with snow. And it's going to be the big one. We're talking about a massive amount, and it's going to be... And I'm like, oh, shit. Now, it's supposed to start, actually, sometime Thursday. I've heard conflicting reports. I've heard later Thursday after the Great Food Giveaway is done. I heard while it's going on, it's going to be getting started. Okay. All right. To me, yeah, it's Jocko. It's Jocko motivation. Hey, it's going to snow during the Great Food Giveaway. Good. Boss, why do you keep saying good? Well, because everything that's bad, something good comes out of it. Been a little too long since we've heard the words of wisdom from Jocko. I think it's time that we do that. Jocko motivation, like one of my favorite things of all time.
He would call me up or pull me aside with some major problem, some issue that was going on. And he'd say, boss, we got this and that and the other thing. And I'd look at him and I'd say, good. And finally, one day he was telling me about some issue that he was having, some problem. And he said, I already know what you're going to say. I said, well, what am I going to say? He said, you're going to say good. He said, that's what you always say. When something is wrong and going bad, you always just look at me and say, good.
What's your problem, boss?
And I said, well, yeah. When things are going bad, there's going to be some good that's going to come from it. Didn't get the new high-speed gear we wanted? Good. Didn't get promoted? Good. More time to get better. Oh, mission got canceled? Good. We can focus on another one. Didn't get funded. Didn't get the job you wanted. Got injured. Sprained my ankle. Got tapped out? Good.
Tapped out?
Good. You learned. Unexpected problems? Good. We have the opportunity to figure out a solution. That's it. When things are going bad, don't get all bummed out. Don't get startled. Don't get frustrated. If you can say the word good, guess what? It means you're still alive. It means you're still breathing. And if you're still breathing, well, then hell, you still got some fight left in you. So get up, dust off, reload, recalibrate, re-engage. And go out on the attack.
There you go. Get after it, he says. I like how Tyler writes, pipe bursting, pipe burst in your house? Good. Diagnosed with cancer? Good. Oh, yeah, good luck with that one. Can you imagine? Diana says, honey, I got cancer. I said, good. Oh, shit. Hang on.
Fucking shit.
Elementary school got shot up. Good. Bomb target a bit off, killing civilians. Good. Your radio co-host turns out to be a pedophile. Good. Zenith takes a shit. Good. Yeah, I can think of the whole... I really don't think you want to have Jocko motivation when school got shot up. I don't think anybody should ever... If someone walked up to Jocko and said, hey, Jocko, everyone in the local school is dead from a gunman. If he said good, I think that might be bad. That might not be good. Oh, my God. Well, anyway, my point was, If the snow is falling, good. It'll look great in pictures. More great examples. Your whole family died in a car crash? Good. So ridiculous. Aram from the doesn't get the joke department.
He was referring to small problems.
What has happened to you? What is going on lately? Are you using drugs or I don't know, something? Is something going on that we don't know about? How can the most ridiculous show, this one, ever, you're like breaking down what he meant? Huh? Holy shit. All right. Anyway. Reason why this comes up is because anonymous person, he prefers to be anonymous. This person at 8:09 last night threw $200 onto the pile of money. Writes, I just tossed a couple of bucks your way while listening to today's podcast. I sent it before I heard Rick top things off. And thanks again to Rick for the $160 donation yesterday from TC Paintball. You're very kind. Yeah, it's fucking amazing. I hope you keep pumping this up for Kids Food Basket, and I appreciate the charity you do. Well, it's the least I could do, you know? I mean, come on. One last thing. As an energy expert in our area, he works for the utility, I believe. Something. He's told me this before. He says, I am genuinely concerned about this impending weather. Power outages will certainly happen through the weekend. I am very much watching the change from light, easy snow to flash fuck you freeze within an hour or two on Thursday evening. I truly hope this forecast changes. If we end up with flash fuck you freeze, followed by a day or so when driving is impossible by crews, there is a very solid chance the holidays could be rough for many of us. And I hope that is not the case. Just planning on working around the clock if things do go sideways. I hope your listeners wrap all their last minute things up on Wednesday. Happy holidays. Hope all is good. Keep those dollars rolling in. Signed, Anonymous. Well, the pleasure is all mine. But I have to admit, when I read it, that you who works in that industry of keeping lights on for people and gas going for people, that got me a little concerned. So I'm like, should I finally go and buy a generator? Like a big fucking, a massive whole home generator. And I'm like, because those things, you know, by the way, it's 12 degrees right now. Those are just ridiculous, and I've always wanted one, but I've never, ever pulled the trigger. That's something you don't think about until the power goes, you know? But I'm thinking maybe I should do this. Just go there and get the fucking thing. But then I'm like, nah, it'll be fine. It'll be fine. And then if the power does go, you know, Queen of the Forest will be there tapping her foot again. Why didn't you get one? I'm like, oh, fuck. Shit. So, be advised. Now, where I am, they're expecting upwards of 18 inches plus of snow. Which, you know, it's winter. You get that. Not the end of the world. I did do one thing yesterday. I put snow tires. I went to the tire place and I said, I need snow tires for this car, and bought snow tires for Diana's car. And not only did I buy snow tires because I constantly, every year, every... Here we go. Yes. I actually bought winter rims this time because every year I have to like take off the all seasons and put on the snow. And that's like $100 a pop, $88 a pop. This time I went, you know what? I'm going to buy the snow tires and I'm going to buy winter rims for this thing. All right. So I am a little concerned about this snow. Just because anonymous person who works in the for the utility brought it up. Again, dear Meathead, Eric at ericzaneshow.com. Let's take a look at what we have. Subject line, dear Meathead, please. Makes it so much easier. Chris has one. Joseph has one. And there's a few... On the, let's see, two more on Facebook. Eric at ericzaneshow.com. Look at him. Look at how adorable this man is. You know, he does not look like he's about to turn 89 years old. He's so sweet. Oh, my God. I love him forever. God. When you see him, you're like, oh, what a sweet man. You would never have thought that he's at one point was an absolute hellraiser. Oh my God. Totally different dude. Sam the Jew weighs in. Heck yeah, Eric. I have my winter tires on black steel rims. Oh yeah. Radio voice Linda, who yesterday was expressing being worried about the weather, and I bawled her out and told her to shut up. She adds, "Who's worried now? Yeah, don't start, OML." Nick says, cheap winter rims, good for when women driver curb stomps the tire. Oh, come on. That's good. Seriously, you're going to get your ass kicked around here. Jesus. All right. Holy shit, it's Christmas. Holy shit. Ba-da-da-da, it's Christmas. As I indicated earlier, I would love you to sign up for Patreon. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. Ad-free, listener-supported. Patreon.com/Eric Zane. Ben and Eric going on Thursday night at 7 p.m. This weekend, we will have another edition of Who Are These Zanes? Debuting at on Saturday. We will be... Part two of the April 23rd, 1993 show from Z93 when Cecil had a paper route. And I also have audio from when I would call other radio stations in Tennessee. And one of them you've heard it's Raining Dicks and Pussies. That one with Gunner. You'll hear that. And I also have another prank that I played when I got on the air on another radio station that you have not heard. And I have some material from about the year 2000, WIMZ in Knoxville, Tennessee, when I did the show with Billy Kidd. May he rest in peace. Still can't believe Billy's not with us anymore. Very, very sad. Okay. The open and live stream of today's show brought to you by Johnson Carpet, one discount outlet. Very, very important that if you need flooring, you pay the lowest price possible. So, go to Johnson Carpet, one discount outlet. Two stores under the name Johnson's. The main showroom, and then just about, quarter mile to the west, the Discount Outlet, which is a big, ugly beige building with a small red sign right behind Little Caesars on the north side of Chicago Drive in Granville, Michigan. Go in there. All the best brands are on the floor ready for you to pay, take off the pile, put into your van or truck, and go home. Cheaper than any other price in the state because they buy so much of it and put it in the warehouse. They know it's going to sell, so they sell it to you for cheaper, get more people in the door. It works. It just freaking works. Now, add an additional 10% off, or take an additional 10% off when you mention my name, okay? So whether you hate the show or love it, just mention my name, and you're going to save a ton of money at Johnson's Carpet One Discount Outlet on Chicago Drive in Granville, Michigan. Go there, say hi to Kent, drop the E out of you, I think is in the audience. I think I read a message from him earlier. Thank you, Kent. All right. The aforementioned Irvine's Auto Repair, Grand Rapids Hybrid and EV. A terrific place to get your vehicle repaired. Any make and model, domestic, Asian, European. The only thing they won't touch is a Volkswagen. They just had a renovation and an increase in their space, so they fix even more cars. 616-532-6600. Ask about a free loaner car. So, you know, you can drop the car off and then you get the loaner car and then you don't have to worry about how inconvenienced you will be if you don't, you're down a car. I mean, you use one of theirs. It's awesome. 616-532-6600. All right. You know, you would never feed your pup mystery meat or spoiled grocery food. So why are those some of the most common protein sources in kibble today? That's right. The ingredient meat meal is often made of spoiled meat and plant scraps. That's a fact. Very gross. That's why Dr. Marty decided to make his own dog food called Nature's Blend. It's a premium freeze-dried raw formula made of turkey, beef, salmon, and duck, which naturally supports your dog's youthful energy, health, and happiness. I've seen the improvement with my dogs, especially their coats, and has a delicious flavor they'll go bonkers for. You got that right, especially O'Neill. He just loses his mind. He loves it so much. Right now, they're offering a special for Eric Zane Show podcast listeners. Grab up to 54% off Nature's Blend by going to drmartypets.com/Zane. That's drmartypets.com/ZANE. Your dog will thank you.
Get ready, Ohio. FanDuel, America's number one sportsbook, is coming to the Buckeye State. And to kick things off, you can get started with $100 in free bets as an early sign-up bonus. Plus, when you sign up today with promo code OhioSB, you'll be all set for when FanDuel goes live in Ohio. Then you can bet on all your favorite teams and all your favorite sports with $100 in free bets. Just download FanDuel's top-rated sportsbook app. It's safe, secure, and super easy to use. Ohio, this is your chance to get in on the action. Join today with promo code OhioSB. Make every moment more with FanDuel, official sportsbook partner of the NFL. 21 plus and present in Ohio. Bonus issued in non-withdrawable free bets that expire 7 days after FanDuel accepts its first real money sports wager in Ohio on 1/1/23. Unique user identity verification required. Offer ends on the go live date. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
If you served in the Vietnam, Gulf War, or post-9/11 eras, you may be eligible for expanded VA benefits. A new law known as the PACT Act provides disability compensation, health care, free toxic exposure screenings, and more to veterans who are exposed to toxins during their military service. You can submit a claim for your PACT Act-related benefits now. Claims received by August 10, 2023 may be paid back to August 10, 2022. Visit va.gov/PACT to learn more and file your claim.
Update on Box O Puppies. Yesterday was the day that Box O Puppies went up for adoption. It was probably 8 weeks ago when I got the word that some sick son of a bitch who needs to burn in hell and is hopefully dead right now took a box of eight puppies that were not yet weaned from mama dog, put them in a box, and left them on the side of the road somewhere in Ottawa County, Michigan, not far from where we are right now. Raining, cold, just above freezing. Some good Samaritan sees the box, looks inside. It's a box of puppies. Holy shit. And they're like, oh my God, we're so cold. Can somebody help us? And, well, cops show up. They call on Harbor Humane. They go, all right, yeah, we got to get this. We're dropping off a box of puppies. Oh my God. And I was concerned about two of the dogs making it through the night. They did. They were named Eric and Zane. It was very, very cute. Side note, I see a comment. Kyle says, are we going to Bosco's after the great food giveaway? Yes, we are. Well, Linda says Bosco's game time decision. I think she's talking about maybe for her or maybe weather related, but the plan is to, yes, go there. Okay, so box of puppies winds up on the door of Harbor Humane. They bring the puppies in. The puppy makes it through the night. Yesterday, they had a big puppy. They have a lot of puppies. So they gave them all away yesterday. Allison writes, wanted to share. The puppy event was a success. All the box of puppies were adopted, as well as almost all the other puppies available. 25 in one day. I think that may be a record. I have the adoption photo of Zane the dog, which I'll show you in a second. We didn't get one of Eric the dog. Eric the puppy, who was adopted. His people slipped out the door before they had a chance. But I'm told he also went to a great home. I'm still really bummed we didn't get to meet up today. Heck, I'm bummed I missed the event. People started lining up at 7 a.m. for these puppies. You're a good puppy. You ain't sassy. You don't lick me in the face. That's nasty. It was apparently madness. To wrap the story up, in the most touching little bow, we invited the deputy who rescued the box of puppies out for a reunion right before we opened. And then it turns out that one of the box puppy fosters knew someone who knew who was the original rescuer, the Good Samaritan. The previously unidentified 911 caller has been located without a FOIA request.
Let's cut the big black dick because I know you want to.
That's her joke, by the way, not mine. Good job. So we had that family come visit too. All the freaking feels WZZM came out to cover, so hopefully it will be on the news tonight. I'll check in a second. This dog, Zane, is going to be a big fella. Here's Zane. Look at him. He just looks like a little bear. Holy shit. And look at the dude. He's so happy wearing his grout fit. Look at that big smile on that guy. He's like, I cannot wait to take this dog home. I love this so much. That's a nice little shot they have there. Nice little Christmas thing going on. All right, so there's that. I wonder if a channel. Okay, hold on a second. I wrote back, oh my God, what a day. I'm so happy it all worked out. You all are the best. I'll read this on the show. Then Allison from Harbor Humane responds with, awesome, thanks for the shout out this morning. I got a chance to listen a bit when I got it back to the office. It's been very, very busy. I haven't been able to listen much. And then she commented, because yesterday I talked about how it's $325. Some troll, after I posted the announcement that the dogs were going to be available for an adoption event and it cost $325 to adopt puppies, some dickhead said, oh yeah, no thanks. $325 for not a purebred puppy, for a shelter puppy. Puh. I'm like, fuck you. She says, also to answer your puppy price line of thought, which thank you for defending us against the trolls. Some people are the worst. You are right. They come fully vetted, as do all our animals. And I challenge someone to find a vet where they can get all of that work done for $325. Heck, these days, I'm sure they get you for $200 for walking in the door. Our puppies are priced higher than adult dogs, partially because they are higher in demand. We lose money on most adoptions, so puppies being priced a little higher helps us fund the long-term senior dog who spends months in the shelter, who we adopt out for $75. So I will speak on behalf of Allison to the troll and say, fuck you. Thanks for all the love, Eric. We appreciate you. I hope WZZM did a story on it. Let's see. Oh, my God. They did.
Oh, my God. Your friends are helping you renovate. You know you owe them dinner, right?
Oh, good.
Schwan's Home Deliveries in the
sassy. You don't lick me in the face, ass nasty.
Freezer to oven to done. Order today at Schwan's.com.
Today, the Harbor Humane Society held a holiday puppy party.
This guy, I've seen this guy before. We're talking major B-team vibes on this dude. He's always so subdued. He's too subdued. My God. And look at that look on his face right now. Looks like he's taking a dump.
For sheltered animals, that included eight puppies found on the side of the road last month. The event was meant to showcase the puppies and other furry friends to find them loving homes. Foster parents who assisted the group.
Oh my God, look at that. Look at these dogs. This one's laughing his ass off as this chick with the crotch is holding the dog. This puppy with the little white feet. There's another puppy. They're all puppies. Holy shit, the room's puppies.
And caring for these puppies attended the event along with Jennifer.
Oh my God.
Who found them that night.
Though these ones right here, these three are Box of Puppies puppies. These three right there. I've actually seen them before.
Benstra said that she was glad to see that the puppies were now.
That's Zane right there.
It was so heartwarming to be able to.
This is the lady who found them.
Connect with Dawn, one of the foster moms. That was amazing. It made all of us happy. I actually could take my husband and kids to see them too. So we had a great time with them, and I hope they go to happy homes that are going to love them forever.
Other main society.
Oh, shit.
Holiday.
Happy homes that are going to love them forever.
Other furry friends are still available to adopt, and if you'd like to.
Oh, my God. That's Eric. That's Eric.
7 p.m. on Beckley Street in West Olive.
You're a good puppy.
Your friends are helping.
You ain't sassy. You don't lick me in the face, ass nasty. Congrats. Very, very cool. Glad they pulled that off. Stevie describes the room full of puppies as heaven right there. Oh, yeah. Like if you could. That's actually a fun topic. If you could pick your heaven, what would it be? And I think that's right up there. I guess it depends on my mood. In a lot of ways, it would be a room full of puppies. A lot of people, I think, would say that. Or perhaps room full of hot older women with no shoes on, stepping around on a dirt floor. That would hot older women, nude. No, well, they don't have to be nude. They can have clothes on just as long as there's bare feet. And they're dragging their feet through mud. Megan writes, it made me so sad when my fosters got adopted. I always cried. Yeah, I think giving away a kidney is easier than being a foster parent. You know, I think that would rip my heart out every time. I wouldn't be able to do it. I think you have to be... A cold, calculated psychopath to be a good foster. And that's obviously not you, Megan, because I know you. I think you need to be like a cold-hearted son of a bitch in order to be a foster. Hang on a second. This thing's acting up again. Shit! You're a good puppy. You ain't sassy. You don't lick me in the face, ass nasty. All right. Boss, Someone came in and killed all the puppies. Good. How'd you like to be a guy in prison on death row and then suddenly you're exonerated after 25 years? This happened in Pennsylvania. And then you show up to a funeral a year later of a former inmate who died and someone shoots you to death. Oh, my God. Lot to unpack on this one. Headline, after 25 years on death row, freed Pennsylvania man is fatally shot at a funeral. So is this one of those where, like, you know, wrong place, wrong time? This is the story of the hurricane where, you know, actually a person who had nothing to do with it whatsoever is in jail? We shall see. Christopher Williams came home from prison in February of 21. He had with him a file folder containing two sheets of paper, which were two signed execution warrants bearing his name. He had served nearly three decades in prison, including 25 years on death row, before being exonerated of four murders and freed. My God. But last week, fatally shot while attending a funeral in North Philly. Williams, 62, who had also been acquitted of two more murders, all involving the same jailhouse informant, had long held a sense that just by surviving, he was defying the odds. Wait a minute here. Okay. A brutal 1989 triple murder, an eager informant, hidden evidence, and now exoneration. Quote, never in the history of the Pennsylvania judicial system has someone been charged with six murders, acquitted of two, and now exonerated of four. So basically, the two, he beat the rap. And then later, there's four more. Now you're going to be put to death for these four. And then they find out, well, you didn't have anything to do with it. No arrests have been made in Friday's shooting. Family and friends of dead guy, who is a father of six kids, said they were shocked by his death. Williams had been driving in a funeral procession for another formerly incarcerated man, Tyree Little, friends said. This is a hit. After stepping out of his car at Mount Peace Cemetery, Williams was shot once in the head. Good. Someone just tuning in will be like, wait, what? The attack also has alarmed other exonerated men who have long expressed fear for their safety after decades in prison. So I think this is like, bullshit, I don't believe you're innocent. Now that you're out, I'm going to kill you. I think that's what we have here. After decades in prison as they fight for potentially large civil settlements, Pennsylvania is among a minority of states that do not offer compensation for wrongfully convicted people. However, Philadelphia has paid out close to $10 million apiece to some exonerees who, like Williams, served 25 years or more in prison. So are they suggesting that when you're going for a large civil settlement, someone is going to kill you? Although we're actually innocent, not everyone believes it, said Theophilus Wilson, who was Williams' co-defendant in a triple murder, and who was also exonerated after close to 28 years in prison. He and Williams were family friends from the city's Germantown section, Williams said. Prosecutors had accused him of being in a gang with Williams and helped him kill three drug dealers from New York. I spent 28 years in jail for knowing him, Wilson said. I have to be on guard. The DA later said in court filings that the case against the men was built on a house of cards involving false jailhouse informant testimony, extensive undisclosed evidence, and forensic evidence that directly contradicted the informant's story. The basic structure underpinning the conviction was built on the unscrupulous behavior of several bad actors. The DA's office concluded, well, how the fuck did you convict him in the first place? Williams, for a couple of years, almost 2 years after getting out, tried reconnecting with his family. He never stopped advocating for others he believed were wrongfully convicted. Okay. He was a soldier, a trooper, a champion for justice. So, according to this, he didn't do anything. He was still learning how to give back. His life had just began, and it was taken from him now. So, I'm not even sure. I need a theory as to what the fuck is going on here. The 1989 murders were violent and callous acts. Three New York drug dealers lured to a housing project to buy guns, robbed of money, loaded into a van, and shot execution style. Good. Their bodies left in different locations in North Philly. As a result of the testimony of a man serving life sentences for six murders, Williams and Wilson were convicted of the gruesome crimes. After maintaining his innocence for close to three decades, since they shot guys who were drug dealers and probably involved with gangs themselves, that what you have here is a retaliatory strike. But they're getting, according to the DA, the wrong guy. So they basically just shot a dude. Fuck. That is crazy. After 25 years on death row, he's freed, and then someone shoots him. So I guess if the DA says, yeah, you're freed, it's up to the DA. Well, that's pretty much all you can do. But if you have someone who thinks you still shot him, my God, this is so fucked up. Chris says, drug dealers going to buy guns. Meh, we're good. Maybe Manitowoc should have killed Avery instead of putting him in prison again. The DA who got him from out behind bars is probably behind it. I don't know about that. Tyler says the Jocko jokes are really cracking me up today. Frankly, I would not have thought of that joke line until you did it. You started it. I applaud you for that. All right. Any more questions? Get them in now. For Dear Meathead, send them along, eric@ericzanejoe.com. Stevie sent one. Thank you, Stevie. I appreciate that. Dear Meathead. Brought to you by Baldwin Ace Hardware. If you're up in that neck of the woods, Baldwin, Michigan, on the edge of the Manistee National Forest, go in there and buy something, won't you? Thank you so much. All right. Let's bring him in here, Dad, for another edition of Dear Meathead. Hey, honey. She's going to say hello.
Good morning, Grand Rapids.
Dad.
Good morning, son.
Hi there. How are you?
I'm well. And how about you and your family?
Never better. Can you hear me okay?
I hear you well, but you're kind of a distance.
Yeah. Hey, make sure Joanne checks the phone. Make sure everything's all right.
It's all right, she said.
Okay, good. Okay, so what do you think about this pending snow, Dad?
I was not excited.
Yeah, it might get pretty intense here. I talked to Joanne yesterday. She said she's just a little worried about losing power. We definitely can't have you guys losing power.
Yeah, that's one of our problems.
All right, somebody will take care of you.
God is great.
So I was thinking about going to buy a generator. What do you think of that?
Not a bad idea, really. It's a good precaution.
You know, just something to have. I just like the idea that in the event that something goes south, you can just grab the generator and make it, you know?
Sure. You know, to the best of my recollection, all the years that we have lived in here, I've never had an issue with electricity.
You have too.
One time we did.
Yeah.
But of course, it's been so far behind us, but I don't even think about it.
Well, I remember it was a few months ago, Marquis had to bring a generator over.
Yeah, he did. Right, he did.
All right, so that
didn't last too long.
All right.
4 days.
It's only 4 days.
maybe you just banished it from your memory. It happens.
Yeah, well, hey, listen. Things come and things go. We're still here.
Dad, we just had a friend of ours. She runs a kind of like a animal shelter for dogs and cats that yeah, and they just had a huge event where people came and adopted a bunch of animals. What's keeping you from adopting a dog, Dad?
You mean for myself?
Yeah.
I don't want to do that, honey. The issue of it, the thing of it is, I don't like to see the thing that goes wrong with them. And then I'm a dog lover from way back. Then I'd be just, I don't know, I'd be crying the blues.
So you're suggesting that if the pet has to go to dog heaven, it would just break your heart?
I could not do that. That's tough. I got, for instance, my granddaughter's got three dogs?
Yeah.
Three dogs. They come up and sit in my lap.
Yeah.
And I like that, you know. And
so you like being a grandparent dog?
I like the visits.
Okay. All right. Fine. You know,
but I see what you're trying to do, but
I'm trying to get you to get a dog. I think it'd be the best.
I know, I appreciate that, honey, but I don't want the agony of the pain when something goes wrong.
Okay, all right. Well, you know, that's definitely understandable. I've been in your shoes before.
Yeah. We've always had dogs.
Now, Dad, today, totally different topic, is actually the first day of winter.
We have a beautiful sunshine here.
Yeah, it's called the winter solstice. So, like, you know, we are officially in winter right now. And Joe's question is, what are some of your favorite fun things to do in the winter?
Right now at this time?
Well, overall, I mean, you've had a long, fantastic life. What have you liked to do in the winter?
Well, snowmobiling was one of my biggest interest that I have.
Yeah,
but at this point in my life, nothing is really
right.
Doing my fancy about winter.
Yeah, I remember when we were kids, you used to take us over to that freaking sledding hill.
Remember that?
Oh yeah, we'd bring hot cocoa and you'd bring some booze.
Oh my gosh, yes.
You'd bring booze.
That was great. I really liked that. You know, I guess my memory is kind of faltering me. You guys did have a lot of good times. In a lot of type of events.
Oh yeah, winter time up north was spectacular. I kind of want to get some snowmobiles myself so that we can all have a big snowmobile adventure, because there's so many places to take sleds up there, you know.
Well, up north there is.
That's what I'm saying.
You have any in your area that you can?
Nah. Well, yes, but I guess so. It does. You don't have to go far where I live now to be able to take them.
The Upper Peninsula or the up north is totally different than what it is.
Yeah.
In a state.
Well, hell, up there, those people don't even drive cars. They just use snowmobiles.
Sure. According to Joanne, we used to ride for miles and miles up there.
Yep. Megan writes, if you had Elf on a Shelf, what would you name him or her?
Wait. Say that again.
First of all, she starts with, hello to the most handsome man who has a yummy...
well, God bless you.
she writes, most handsome man who has a yummy sandwich named after him.
Your speaker is faltering.
I think it's yours, actually.
Well,
yeah, I don't
somebody
know.
Is.
Maybe yours is a little too loud on your end. I think it's feeding back.
No, it says stopping and going.
Exactly. So if you drop the volume down just a couple little ticks, it'll correct itself. Okay. She writes, hello to the most handsome man who has a yummy sandwich named after him.
Well, thank you, honey.
And then she says, if you had the elf on the shelf, what would you name your elf on a shelf?
Wait a minute. My elf?
Yeah. Are you, don't you know what elf on a shelf is, Dad?
Yeah. I would call him, hey, you.
The name of the elf is hey, you?
Yeah. Hey, you.
Okay. All right. Very good.
I'm not into fancy stuff.
Why would you call the elf hey, you? Wouldn't you give him a name like, Mike?
I would probably call him a meathead.
You call, of course.
I have no idea what I would call, really.
All right. Stevie writes, hello, Ruben. I love gingerbread cookies.
Oh.
And she says, I just can't wait for them to come out of the oven. What is your favorite Christmas treat?
Well, you just mentioned that right there is a great one. But what is that, Joanne? I don't remember the thing that I ate.
Your favorite treat?
Yeah.
Gosh, I don't know. You love everything.
Actually, yeah, according to her, I love everything.
Yeah, I think you've said many times that if this, anybody puts any food in front of you, you will eat it.
Prime rib would be good.
Yeah, that's what you have. Oh, yeah. You like lamb chops.
Lamb chops.
Where Jerry's going to cook for you.
Yeah, now, there is, by the way, I'm cooking leg of lamb.
Ooh.
That's a little different than lamb chops, but leg of lamb is what we're going to have when I visit you on January 1.
We'll chop it up.
Yes, you're going to chop it up yourself. Okay. Nathan asked, dear Meathead, do you have any good Christmas stories?
Christmas story? No, not really. Well, the greatest stories that I have is when Christmas time or this time of the year, we went up north sledding and snowmobiling. That's the greatest. She's got a great story.
She does. What is her story?
Drinking days when you were married to Bernie and you packed up all the presents and was going to put them under the tree for the kids and you fell down the stairs.
Oh yeah.
Coming downstairs.
I remember that. I remember you laying at the bottom of the steps with packages on top of you.
That's my favorite story, Eric.
Yeah, that's so funny.
All the presents are all over.
Oh, yeah. The dog's licking your face trying to get you to wake up.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Allison has a question. Dear Meathead, I need you to settle a debate. What is the best Christmas meal? Is it turkey, ham, or something else?
Prime rib.
I agree. You can't go wrong with prime rib, for God's sake.
Oh.
Yeah. Fantastic. Okay, good. All right.
You guys are having a big powwow out there?
Not really. It's just me, Diana, and Kevin.
Where's Maddie
going to
be?
Where's Maddie?
Well, she'll be there, too, but I think she... I don't know what the hell is going on. She might be working or something like that. We're actually not celebrating Christmas until the 26th. So, on that day, we'll all be together. So.
Oh, well, yeah.
Okay.
Gotcha. I had one more. Where the hell is it?
Okay.
I thought I did. I just lost it. I can't find the damn thing. Okay. That's all I got for you. Anything else going on that we need to talk about?
Well, I tell you, we got the great sunshine right now.
Yeah, it looks nice. It looks nice.
4 hours from now.
It looks nice, but it's going to get bad. I just realized I have one more question for you. This is from Chris. He says, dear Meathead, I have a strand of Christmas lights that stopped working. Okay. It has 800 bulbs, and it only costs $30.
Oh, my God.
He says, I've checked the first 50 bulbs and have not fixed it. Would you Should I keep it and keep trying to fix it, or should I just throw the whole thing out and get a new one?
Throw it away.
Yeah,
it's not worth the time and agony that you got to go through.
I remember, yeah, really. I mean, seriously, it's. Do you put Christmas lights up on your place?
Well, we did. We used to. Right now, we're down to two.
This is the first year
we got two Christmas
on the garage
wall.
The green light and the red light.
Well, you got more than me.
Yeah, we got green and what is it? Green and red.
Garage. Yeah, that's the bare minimum. I love it. Chris writes, also, I have a lot of snow on my lawn and a big asphalt driveway. Should I let the snow melt on its own, or should I shovel a little bit at a time onto the driveway when it's sunny out, like you, Meathead?
I'll tell you what. Unfortunately, I'm a bug about snow and shovel.
Yeah.
I shovel them, Bush. I definitely do. But right at this point, everybody is watching me, what I'm doing.
Yeah, they think you're crazy because you're shoveling the grass.
Well, no, I only do the driveway.
No, you shoveled the grass last year.
Yeah. Well, yeah, what is your opinion about shoveling the grass, Dad?
I don't think I should do that because you damage the grass quite a bit.
Well, yeah, but if there's a pile of snow that comes from the driveway, as soon as the temperature gets to be 33 degrees, don't you then take a shovel and try to melt it with a hairdryer or something?
I will only open up a path for walking.
Okay.
Well, not right now. I mean, I don't do what I used to do.
I can't. Okay, well, if you do, that's okay. I like that you do that, you know?
Well, they're watching me from blowing my nose, even.
Oh, they're people. Oh, you mean the neighbors are, like, keeping an eye on you?
My wife is the biggest keep an eye on me.
Oh, okay, fair enough. I get it. All right, well, everybody wishes you guys a very Merry Christmas, and we just love you so much. This is incredible that we have another year of Christmas together, so I'm looking forward to that. And
Amen. But I want to tell you something. You've got one of the most wonderful audiences.
Oh, I know it. They are the best, Dad. There's no question. I
really appreciate them.
They love you, and they freaking just think the world of you guys. So,
thank you, likewise, and I wish you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, honey.
Okay, Dad, I love you guys.
Love you too.
All right, okay. And please, please, please be safe.
Oh yeah, we'll be fine. We'll be fine.
Okay.
Okay. Talk to you.
All right.
Bye bye.
We'll talk to you next week for sure.
Yes, sir.
God bless.
God bless. Bye bye. Josh writes, favorite meal, raw hamburger straight from the package. Oh, without a doubt. Without a doubt. All right. Very cool. Thank you so much for being part of Dear Meathead. Chris in Maine calls him a legend. Chris sent a nice, his question was the one about the melting the snow. I believe that was the Chris. Chris also sent the nicest freaking email yesterday. Oh, my God. What did he write? Merry Christmas, Zaner. He writes, as we close in on the big winter holiday, I want to extend a random thank you from a random Windy Road. Wait. Windy? You mean windy? Want to extend a random thank you from a random Windy Road that brought me to become a fan of your show. You make levity and celebrate wholesomeness alongside dark humor. All right, I guess so. A mix only a cocksucker like you could. See, this is my idea of a nice email. This guides me, he writes. Many would laugh or be appalled that this is what brings me ease, but it actually truthfully does. I share the love of a getaway to Fear Bunker North. Jackman, Maine, for us. Yeah. who was it? What's the guy's name? JJ Gray said, if you got it, you hold on to it. This is for those who got a Lock Lusa. That's our, that's your Lock Lusa, Jackman, Maine. He says, and before this becomes a damn novel, there is so much more I could say, but it's about being happy and, to your point, entertained. One that would give you the shirt off their back and then tell you to shut the fuck up is something I can relate to, and that is good enough for me. I listen to every show, many live on Twitch, and when I miss a few in a row for whatever reason, I find plenty of time behind the wheel or wherever to catch up on Stitcher. Wish you and your family all the best ever over Christmas and a healthy and happy new year. Thanks, Maine Chris. Appreciate that, Chris. You're a good man. You're a good puppy. You ain't sassy. You don't lick me in the face. That's nasty. All right. Okay. Advertise on the Eric Zane Show podcast. Reach out, eric@ericzaneshow.com, and I'll tell you how it works. Working on some new ones right now. As we migrate our way to the four-year anniversary of the Eric Zane Show podcast, coming up January 6th. It's crazy that on January 6th. Hang on. The anniversary of the world's biggest asshole convention is also the anniversary of this show. Mine was first, though. January 6, 2019. 1 year later, January 20, 2020. Wait, January 6, 2020, right? Was it January 6, 2020? I think it was. Advertise with me, eric@ericzaneshow.com. Thank you to Bosco's Pub. We're going to be there tomorrow, after we get done with the great food giveaway. Extremely excited about that. Bosco's Pub, part of Terra Square in Hudsonville. Go there for burgers. Please mention my name. Burgers and beers. My Policy Shop Insurance, Frank Fuss. When Frank's not busting my balls, he's making sure that you are appropriately covered with health care through healthcare.gov. Now, he can help you with all different types of insurance needs. Could be life, home, car, anything. Social Security, Medicare. Whatever you need, Frank has your back. Call him at 616-914-4070. 616-914-4070. For My Policy Shop Insurance. Thank you to Frank. I'm on Cameo. Hire me, cameo.com/Eric Zane. I got a mortgage guy. Mario Flores, Lakeshore team of Van Dyke Mortgage. 231-332-6505. Call today. If you want to refi, get money out of your home to pay a high interest credit card, maybe your first mortgage, maybe your 10th mortgage. Get the mortgage from Mario. There's only four states that you cannot utilize, that cannot utilize the services. They are Alaska, Maine, Hawaii, South Carolina. Other than that, have at it. No matter where you are, five gold stars service. Five-star gold star service. Jesus. With the Mario Flores Lakeshore team of Van Dyke Mortgage. God bless Rick from TC Paintball. Don't worry about his hard outer shell. I think that's how you say it. Dropping $160 to put us over for the great food giveaway. You are awesome. Thank you. TC Paintball online at tcpaintballgr.com. End of the year closeouts, big savings. Go to TC Paintball, walk in and wheel and deal. Remember I said to Rick, I go, is this type of thing where when people want to buy shit from you, they like, oh man, I only wanted to pay. They're like bargaining with you, trying to bring you down. He goes, oh, yeah, it happens all the time. So go and talk him down. TCPaintballGR.com. But don't, hey, Rick is not afraid to walk away from a deal. So be careful. And book a paintball event at TC Paintball online at TCPaintballGR.com. So much fun. Oh, my God. We have an event coming up January 15th. Right now, only Tyler and me. It's just going to be Tyler and me shooting at each other for this event. Accesskent.com/health. That is the website for my friends at the Kent County Health Department. Thank you to them for giving me the opportunity to speak about all their great initiatives like the WIC program, immunizations for the kids at school, measles, mumps, rubella, whooping cough, pertussis, meningitis, you name it. You can get those for little or no cost. Personal health services and getting tested for sexually transmitted infections, also very, very important. Accesskent.com/health. I have to go tinkle. Cue Aram making a dumb joke or a comment because I have to use the restroom in 3, 2, 1. Okay. Don't go anywhere. I will be right back. All right. Intermission over. Over. So Mike Ball, who, of course, helps with the great food giveaway, longtime friend, sent me this video. A link to a video. Some guy shot it from his car. It's right happened right out in front of the Little Debbie Bakery where in Chattanooga, where Mike, you know, peddles Little Debbie shit. He stopped. Well, I shouldn't say that. He didn't peddle anything. He's the guy in this area who gets the Little Debbie snacks and then puts them, stocks all the stores. MB Distributing. He says, hey, this video is from right in front of the bakery. Some trucker, there was a red light, and he's transporting these giant concrete beams. Like wide load, one of those deals. And at the red light, like a car would be there, but, you know, if you're at the light, which is near the railroad tracks, the way they have it set up, it's kind of wonky. I can't believe that this doesn't happen more often. If you put a truck at the light, whatever it's pulling behind it is going to be on the railroad tracks. So I can't. This sounds to me like all operator error to actually have the truck across the tracks, and then, a train is coming, and the guy who shot the video, audio check, video check, is like, oh my God, he like gets ready. He's got plenty of time to see the lead up to it. So this is incredible. Look at, look at how long this is. That's the problem. So the light is down the street here, okay? And it's backed up, but he doesn't have enough sense. He should have waited on this side of the tracks until what's happening in front of him, the backup by the light, clears. But no, ding dong, he puts the fucking thing on the tracks. And so this is how it unfolded. Let's take a look at this. Oh man, this is intense.
Oh no.
Oh, look at this. Look at this. If you're the guy in the truck, you just are like, oh, fuck. I would have stepped on the gas.
What a mess, Priscilla. Oh, no. Oh, no, no, no.
Now the train's derailing. No. Look at this shit.
Oh. Gotta
get the fuck out of there.
Something blows up.
One more time. Did you see that thing derail?
Oh no. What a mess, Priscilla. Oh no. Oh no, 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 no.
Look at that. Oh. My God. That dude gets the hell out of there. Jesus. Ah. What an absolute catastrophe. Holy shit. Train derails? Good. More chance to apply for other trucking jobs. Oh, my God. Let's see. A train collided with a truck carrying a 134 concrete truss beam in Collegedale, Tennessee, resulting in 13 train cars derailing, minor injuries, according to authorities. Footage recorded by Mark A. Walwin shows a Norfolk Southern train smashing into a tractor trailer carrying the beam, causing the derailment. Three locomotives and 10 cars derailed and slammed into each other. Man, the guy, Jesus. If you're the trucker, that is, what the fuck? Now, yeah, there's no way that guy's going to be working anymore. While I was looking at that, I saw this one too. Apparently, this is a place on Facebook where there's all sorts of transportation disasters. Audio check, video check. In this one, the guy driving the garbage truck, he's going to hit this bridge. He's not even close. The bridge is much lower than the height of the truck. No sound. Oh, so he hits the bridge and then kablooey. The whole thing goes up in flames. Shit. Oh, my God. It happened back in late November. Jesus. According to the local news outlet, the driver was not hurt. Come on, guys. I remember one time I hit the Mackinac Bridge. I shouldn't talk. I actually struck. Well, I didn't. I take it back. I was driving up to it, and I stopped at the absolute last second. In my mind, I hit it, but I didn't. I was driving up to right where the Mackinac Bridge starts, and there's a spot where you can drive under the last span before you're over the water. And I had the RV, and there's a sign, a height requirement. And I know, well, as I was about to hit it, I stepped on the fucking brakes, and I was like, and I looked and I go, there's no way we're going to make that. And I got out and looked at it, and I could see clearly I was going to do what that dude in the garbage truck did. I would have been on the news. Asshole in RV strikes Mackinac Bridge. Oh, boy. Super scary. What an asshole. I didn't do it, though. Good to go. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for us to take another trip around the radio dial. Going to start on the far left, as always. See what it brings us. Mm-hmm. Song just ended. Sounds like NPR. Oh, I like that. Second time we've Shazam music on this NPR shit.
Got to give me some new teeth. Got to get under the underneath. Smokestack lightning taking all my shine. Got to drink me some good red wine.
Some guy named Greg Brown. Where are you going when you're gone? I love that.
Extra important job you have. Let's reduct. What you do, Caitlin?
Good morning.
statement is this Department of...
I want to hear this.
County Department of Public Works. We really oversee all municipal solid waste for the county. And so we play an important role in our community, not only taking care of our closed landfills, but we also operate
existing landfill. We operate the Recycling Education Center. And so that's what we're really here today to talk about is recycling, what we can do this holiday season. During the holidays, we generate typically
25% more waste than we do any other time of year. And so a lot of
what
people
a conversation.
Are asking, what do I do with my wrapping paper?
What a what fucking do I do with annoying conversation
so
this
we're
is.
Here to help you
we're here to help you
dispose of, those
dispose of your wrapping
Caitlin,
paper.
What do I do with my wrapping paper?
Throw it away.
Good question. So wrapping paper usually contains a lot of heavy dyes, sometimes additives like metallic foil that make it glittery and sparkly. But those things can't be made into new
boy,
paper.
This is embarrassing.
So the best thing that we can
someone
do
would
is
actually listen and go, oh, this is so informative. I'm so entertained with what I should like do with my gift wrap.
Oh, she's digging.
Yes, I do have wrapping paper.
And it may not make sense.
Pastor Steve Harvey.
The Bible's full of God asking people to do what would appear to be ridiculous things that didn't make sense, but is what God wanted to test their faith. So they removed the stone, verse 41, Jesus raised his eyes and said, well, the most important word in verse 41 is then. Somebody say then.
Amen. Then,
meaning not until she removed the stone.
Yeah.
Then.
Okay, more religion. You guys want me to sing another devil voice Christian song?
Come on, you two.
In royal David's city stood a lonely cattle shed.
I can't get into it.
I just can't do it. I don't want to go back to the well. Besides, it's a chick's voice, so it's harder to do devil voice for some reason.
An option at treatcovid19.com. This message is sponsored by Pfizer.
Additional terms and conditions apply. Visit Verizon.com for offer details. Up to $1,900 value based on iPhone, Apple Watch, iPad, and Beats.
The share it with
Bob
a friend
says,
deal.
Devil voice free beer and hot wings when you get there. How much you want to bet they're in commercial?
Your McDonald's, your. I don't
think we could help. It's different here.
Sports talk. I mean, the best ability is availability. I think if you know, both of those guys are super.
All right, I'm already bored.
Offer not valid in all states or where prohibited by law. Loans are subject to lender
approval. That's LAV.
Wait.
I doubt it may be because they have a high risk
River of illness,
such as heart disease, diabetes.
I'll come back to it later.
Day weather-wise, so you can wrap a lot of stuff.
Andy Rent.
For you right now. Here's some Indian on the river.
Can't even get this station in.
Were made by him.
Cole writes, radio host makes fun of pants. Good. Replacement host beats woman allegedly. Good. More chance to get better.
John 1 verses 1 through 4. And we'll come back to that in just a moment.
Now, how can he be God and the Son of God at the same time?
I don't know.
How can he be God the Son and the Son of God?
Don't ask me.
This is what we're going to call the doctrine of the Trinity.
Doctrine of the Trinity.
What child is this? If he is God, a very God, then there is a doctrine taught in the Bible called the Holy Trinity. And to negate that doctrine is the source of heresy. Islam.
Stupid.
God. Sometimes people say, well, Islam believes in one God. And Christians believe in one God. And Jews believe in one God.
Oh, here we go.
Isn't it wonderful we all believe in the same God? If they don't believe in the Trinitarian God, they don't believe in the same God.
You're going to get killed by some Muslim.
Just because you believe
Muslim.
In one God.
They're going to put a fucking fatwa on us.
We can
or
say
on
that
you,
Tennessee
not
has
me.
One capital. One person says it's
Nashville. I don't think you speak for everyone, you asshole.
We believe in one capital. No, things that are different are not the same.
Do you guys know that?
Islam does not believe
Did you guys know that Islam, Jews, and Christians all believe in the same God? Well, this guy seems to think so. How do you know that, you asshole?
Mormons do not believe in the Trinitarian God. Our
this
dear
is
Jewish
bad.
Friends reject the idea of a Trinitarian God. You say, Pastor, what is this Trinitarian thing that you're talking about?
This guy.
What I'm trying to say to you is...
I'm a dumb fuck.
And this truth that is taught in the Word of God is a stumbling block to many people.
With buy one, get one for a dollar. Grab your favorite like a McDouble, McChicken, or small fry.
Christmas polka.
For Christmas, you know, having to pass this big stinkeroo, $1.7 trillion.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't anticipate that it's going to get much better even with the
Pudding.
With
this
the
is the Pudding Show
in charge. But we.
Steve?
Yes, I do.
Rachel, would you like to play from your
water box?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's start with. Ooh. I am very old.
Kelly.
Kelly?
Bob Barker.
No.
Listen
I am
to,
very old.
Listen to her on devil voice.
I am no physicist, but I know about force. Hot wings. Yoda. That's fine for hot wings.
No! Yes!
Turn this back on.
At the point.
What? What am I? I live... outdoors.
Steve.
Halsey. If you get this, I will give you $100 cash.
A squirrel.
No.
By the way, the buzz is me. I'm adding the buzzer. And the
I
bell.
Look out upon the earth. I protect something valuable.
Joe. Oh. Punch her in the face.
I wear old clothes.
Joe. Kick her in the twat. Joe.
People think birds are afraid of me.
Chief!
Joe!
You already went.
Abuse!
Rachel.
Scarecrow.
Yes. Joe!
Oh!
Joe!
She gets a point.
Beat the shit out of a woman! No!
I see how there's anyone listening is like, I have never thought of a scarecrow being scared.
How come you guys can't hear me?
Life.
Joe!
First time they realized that one word's actually two smashed together.
By the way, this show is a work of fiction. Names, characters, places, and incidents are either products of Eric Zane's imagination or are used fictitiously. Any resemblance to actual events or locales or persons living or dead is entirely coincidental. I want to play.
I am where Jason went to look for the Golden Fleece.
Eric Zane.
Howard.
Joe.
Howard's. Greece. Incorrect.
Kelly. Rome.
No.
No. Joe.
Started with I am a country.
Spousal abuse. No.
Stalin's birthplace.
Joe. Wreck Thanksgiving.
Oh boy. I have more King Georges than any other country.
Steve.
England? No, Rachel. You get them all. You might think I'm part of Russia. I don't like Vladimir Putin.
Oh, Eric Zane, Ukraine!
I was going to give you the last one, but if you want to go with Ukraine, you can. That is incorrect. The answer, Orange Blue, is my name begins with a G.
Oh, I thought it was going to be...
What?
Like a state.
Georgia! Georgia!
Georgia!
No! Yes! Eric Zane, Georgia! Why can't I play?
Ready? Who am I? My initials used to be JK. No kidding.
Rowling!
I lived from 1921 until 1994.
JK. Used to be JK. Well, why are they not his initials anymore?
The 60s was my decade.
My initials used to be JK.
The White House Bears.
Kelly.
Alex. Jackie Kennedy Onassis. Correct.
Oh, I get it. See, she changed her name.
6 points. Kelly and Steve tied.
Fucking shit. I should have known that one, guys. How come you guys are ignoring me?
I can sometimes be very private.
Howings, Howings. Eric,
most people visit me for more than 10 years.
Cicadas. Eric Zane, cicadas.
More than 10 years?
Mm-hmm. Kelly.
Kelly.
Church.
No.
No, not church, you dummy. Are you kidding me?
I can sometimes be public.
Listen, now I want to know this.
Sometimes I am religious.
For 10 years, sometimes I'm religious. I don't, what the fuck?
Males and females normally participate together, but not always.
The Olympics? No. Eric Zane.
Without me,
Olympics.
We would have no doctors.
Without,
I'm also the name for a group of fish. Owings. Owings. School. Yes.
School! Fuck.
Yeah. Terrible.
All right. I can play that game all day. Fucking great. A lot of bad guesses from me, though. My apologies. All right. So there's this dude who is like, actually, let me get to this one. Thank you. I think Stevie sent this along. Doctors are warning. Don't let this happen to you. This is X-ray of a candy cane in, I'm guessing, a vagina. That's a legit image. And it appears to be, it's either a candy cane or some type of Christmas ornament. And someone stuck it in hook and first. Okay. And they were hoping to use the straight end as a handle to get it out. But whoever this was couldn't actually get it out. So they had to go to the doctor with a candy up one of their orifices and say, hey, can you please get this out of there? Doctors are warning, do not masturbate with ornaments. How can you possibly think that that's a good idea? And how could you be so like, oh, wow, this needs to go up my ass just because it's shaped in a particular way that could, I guess, penetrate, but I mean, it's fragile. There's nothing about Christmas that's, when it comes to decorating, that's durable, that could be used for a device that goes into your body. All right. Jesus. This is a trend, according to a UK doctor. It is not advisable to masturbate with Christmas ornaments, says Dr. Sarah Welsh, a gynecologist who told Need to Know online. She was listing the dildos or dildos and don'ts of the scandalous Yuletide tradition, which sees people being hospitalized after getting frisky with everything from glass baubles, B-A-U-B-L-E-S, to candy canes. My God. Boy, listen to Daisy snore. She's picking up on the meter. It's registering on the dog Richter scale. Indeed, trying to make Christmas come early with ornaments is apparently hazardous to one's health. Christmas ornaments can have sharp aspects or pieces that can break during masturbation, which can cause soreness. More than that, it could cut you. It could cut your vagina or your butthole. The risk of trauma and are just generally unsuitable for your vagina, Warren Welsh, who co-founded the condom brand Hanks. In other words, leave your elf on the shelf come Christmas time. That's just stupid. Every Christmas confections pose a threat due to the hygiene issues. Concern about pieces breaking off or the sugar content of items such as candy canes. Anything with sugar in it such as a Christmas confectionery should also stay away from the vagina, as this disrupts the delicate ecosystem of the vaginal microbiome and can predispose you to vaginal thrush infections. Oh my God, that sounds terrible. Refrain from pleasuring yourself with these so-called sexmas toys that might seem like a no-brainer. However, this unfortunate phenomenon is more common than one would think. A case study from 2013 mentions people inserting glass baubles and even turkey basters inside of themselves. I mean, if there was no other options, I could see this, but you can, fuck, you can, we heard from Marjorie What's-Her-Face Green, you can go to Walgreens and get the best fucking dildo money can buy. Anywhere, they're at like on the end cap. It says, stick this in your vagina. You walk by, oh, what, great, stick this in, inside of my mother. Great, there you go. Meanwhile, a social media post in a paramedic Facebook group described instances of holiday hornballs, not sure what that is, improvising with a candy cane and a tree decoration, along with photos showing the graphic x-rays from each. Oh, yeah, look at, I didn't even show you this one. This x-ray of a glass bauble. I guess that's a round thing that you put on the tree. I can't imagine being such a loose vagina that you could pull that off. Hang on. I mean, with any degree of success. I mean, talk about it. I mean, even if you do get it in there, getting it out is a struggle. You got to have some type of handle, you know? Cole writes, and these are his words, not mine, candy cane stuck in pussy. Good. Let's see. Meanwhile, a social media post. Okay, I read that. X-ray show a candy cane and a Christmas ball ornament stuck in rectums. They put that in their butt? This is the lady who says, yeah, don't stick anything up your butt. She's kind of cute. That's her. She said, yes, keep this out of your butt and your vagina. Don't stick stuff in there. Okay? According to data from the UK's National Electronic Injury Surveillance System, there were 13,213 cases in which people aged 25 to 64 inserted decorating items into their bodies in 2021 alone. You have got to be kidding me. The fact that they keep numbers on this. Oh, add another one. Experts attributed the use of these festive foreign objects to autoeroticism, which Merriam-Webster defines as the sexual gratification obtained solely through stimulation by oneself of one's own body. It's not just Yuletide baubles that have been found in peculiar orifices. Last fall, a person from Michigan, a dude, got 6 kidney beans lodged in his pee hole, his urethra. This is known in the medical community as sounding. Meanwhile, now, you know, my God, if you're going to get sexual gratification from sticking something in your pee hole, now, ultimately, that's the exit point for semen, which, when you orgasm, would come out of that hole. So, what's going on there? Are you going to put that in your ding-dong and then have an orgasm and then it all backs up? That sounds horrible. Or am I missing out on something fantastic? I mean, do any of you do this? In September, a 27-year-old man in India had to be hospitalized after allegedly shoving a deodorant canister up his butt which remained there for 3 weeks before doctors removed it. So his option, his best option was to leave it up there and hope it would go away. And how about guy putting kidney beans up his piss hole, his urethra? I mean, can you imagine just the look of disbelief when he has to show up at the hospital and he has to tell this story several times because you have the person who's there at the front say, oh, yeah, hi, how can I help you? Yeah, I'm here to I have a medical emergency. I need to see a doctor. Okay, what's the problem? It's, he has to say, well, I took kidney beans and put them up my dick hole. The sheer shock and trauma of that person on the other side of the glass who has to hear that. And then trying not to laugh. And then, you know, you go and the triage nurse, you're sitting there and you're like, oh, yeah, I got some shit up my dick. And I would like to think that they've heard everything, but not that. Not that. Some guy in Michigan did that. Okay. I'm guessing his first name is Boring. His last name is Dean. Okay. Probably a lonely man. Hideously ugly. Known for beating jokes into the ground. Probably few friends. Less sexual opportunities. Probably tried to have sex with a lady named Melinda from Tennessee and his dick wouldn't work. So now he sticks kidney beans up there. Most of that is true. Got kidney beans stuck up your dick? Good. Another shot of the doctor who's telling you don't stick shit up your dick hole. What a cutie. A little too young for me. What is she? What do you think? She's like 34? Gross. No way. Get out of here with that young shit. Hot chick says there are many suitable and certified sex toys on the market available that will do a much better job. She also adds, avoid products under the brand name Pure Romance. That's what she says. Not my words, hers. She says, avoid any scams from the company known as Pure Romance. Those are horrible products. All right. I think that's about my time. My work is done here on the show. But we have more show coming up on the Patreon bonus podcast. Ad-free, listener-supported. No such thing as a donate button for the Eric Zane Show podcast. Sign up for the Patreon. That's how you do it. $5 or $10 a month. And you get 11 bonus episodes per week. So much fun stuff to talk about. Tomorrow, the Ben and Eric Patreon podcast happens. Oh, my gosh. Before I leave you, though, we have the asshole of the day and a word about A&E Heating and Cooling, 616-516-8579. The man who gave us forbidden Spanish.
Tu madre es una puta. Comes chingo de cagada.
I love that one. That one, he's saying, eat tons of shit.
Comes chingo de cagada.
Comos chingos.
Comes chingo de cagada.
Comos chingo.
Comes chingo de cagada.
Comos chingo de cagada.
Comes chingo de cagada.
Que gaga. What?
Comes chingo de cagada.
I can't do it. A&E Heating and Cooling, 616-516-8579. Call and say,
comes chingo de cagada.
Eat tons of shit to save 0% at A&E Heating and Cooling. Get your furnace tuned up, all right? Cleaned, tuned, so it's running efficiently. Saves wear and tear. Your furnace will live longer. It'll run more efficiently. It will cost you less to burn gas in your home or whatever it is you burn. 616-516-8579. The car dealership of choice is Sarah Honda Granville. S-E-R-R-A. SarahHondaGranville.com. Go to the actual place of business, the campus, if you will. That's where they have Michigan's largest selection of certified pre-owned vehicles. That's where they have all of the brand new cars that you can test drive. That's where all of the folks work every day, making sure that you get in the car of your dreams. And so when you go there and test drive, you're probably not going to drive off the lot that day unless the truck just arrived with fresh new vehicles that just came in. But the way they do it nowadays is you then sit down and pick out all the options you want on the car, want or don't want. Pay for the car, get the financing if that's what you want, or if you're loaded with, if you're cash heavy, you just buy the thing. Wouldn't that be great? And then a couple weeks later, your vehicle shows up, they prep it, they put gas in it, and off you go. Pay for the good floor mats, by the way. That's the one thing. You know how they always try to get you to spend more money after you buy the car? On whatever, extended warranty or undercoating. The one thing you absolutely should buy is the freaking floor mats. And mention my name, please, when you go there. Sarah Honda Granville. Even if you want to get a shitbox car, there's a row of cars. It says Eric Zane's shitbox vehicles. No, it doesn't say that. It says budget. And these are the ones that, you know, are going to get you to work and back. Okay? I wouldn't take them on any long trips. But they do sell those cars. If you need a budget car, they'll get you one. Sarah Honda Granville. S-E-R-R-A. SarahHondaGranville.com. The flooring installer that I want you to put all the flooring in that you buy from Johnson Carpet One Discount Outlet is Bennett Flooring Installation, 616-318-0167. Online at BennettFlooringInstallation.com. Reach out to them, 616-318-0167. Jacob will pick it up. And off you go. Book him to come to your house and measure the room that you want the flooring installed in. Okay? You can get full service where he takes out the old flooring if that's what you want. It's going to cost you a little more. Highly recommended, though, that you do the dirty work, getting rid of the old flooring. It's going to save you a ton of money. Not all flooring people are created equal. They might not recommend that. But Jacob's like, do whatever you got to do to save money. This is the least expensive way to have flooring professionally installed. 616-318-0167. Okay? All right. See, we got some new people in here. GG Breezy. I think you're new. Either you're new or I just haven't seen you. But thank you. You just subscribed to Tier 1. On Twitch. So I appreciate that very much. And there's also this BW Ionia. I think you're new as well. Welcome. I appreciate that very much. Please spread the word that this show is up and running. BW Ionia says, nope, I'm Ben. Ben who? Which Ben? I know lots of Bens. Ben Glaze? Not Ben Glaze, right? I don't know. Ben Weller, there you are. Oh, my God. Sorry, Ben. I appreciate you very much. Okay, we have the asshole of the day coming up. Right now, in fact. Brought to you by TC Paintball. Diana thought I was the asshole of the day when I caused the when I had zero money, minus $800 in the bank account when she was ready to pay for shit at the dollar store. Of course, a lot of love with the great food giveaway. Thank you so much. Oh, my God. Anonymous told me about the vicious snow that he's expecting, and he's worried, which kind of gets me worried. An update on the puppies. Dude on death row shot and killed. Dear Meathead was great. Up and down the radio dial. Guy who parked truck on train tracks. Oh, yeah, that's going to be it. I was going to put me, but no, I'm going to change that. Guy who parked on tracks. You got one job, for fuck's sake. Brought to you by TC Paintball. Guy who parked on train tracks is your asshole of the day. Okay, that's it. All right. Tomorrow's a big day. I'll have podcasting for you to start the day, and then great food giveaway, and then Bosco's, and then more podcasting with Ben. Oh, my God. So much to do tomorrow. Thank you, folks. I love you, and I appreciate you very much. As always, you are the best. And I'll talk to you on Patreon. Have a good one, folks. Till next time. Bye-bye.
This episode is brought to you by Zelle. Whenever you're sending money through an app or online, it's important to do it safely. Here are a few helpful tips. First, always make sure you know and trust the person you're sending money to. Second, confirm you have entered their contact details correctly. And finally, if you don't trust the person or your recipient is rushing you to send money right away, think twice before sending money through an app or online.
As children grow up, they face a lot of choices. Choices that affect their future or determine their character. Families can support their choices with a Met prepaid tuition savings program where you pay for future education at today's prices. It's a safe, secure way to give them a debt-free start or get back at least what you put in, often more, if they choose a different path. Because you can't predict the future, but you sure can prepare for it. Start saving today at setwithmet.com.